Miller's commentator on the big stories of the day, and tonight, with public anger around Just Stop Oil protesters, Michael Gove casting doubt on net zero, and with voters in London rejecting a new scheme to charge them £12.50 a day for the privilege of driving their cars, are green policies now a vote loser? Let's put that to tonight's newsmaker, former government minister, best-selling author and television personality Anne Widdecombe. Good evening, Anne. Lovely to have you back on the show. The former environment secretary there, Michael Gove, pushes back on the race for net zero, saying it mustn't be a crusade, hinting at what many of us think, that this has become a religion. Have the Tories woken up and smelt the coffee?
Well, I think they may have woken up a bit. I mean, Reform UK has been saying this for a very long time, that there's a complete lack of any proportionality in the drive towards net zero. People are going to be required to install expensive boilers. They're going to be required to buy expensive electric cars. And now, you know, there was a proposal that would have meant that every time they drove into London, they were going to be hit with a charge if their cars weren't compliant. And it's a complete lack of proportionality. Now, as I've said before, you know, we contribute 1% towards the world's carbon emissions. China, over 20%. You know, now, what is the point of Britain putting on a hair shirt and getting completely disproportionate and having, you know, unmovable targets when, in fact, we contribute so little? And I think what the public are saying is they're not saying we reject the whole climate change agenda. What they're saying is we want some proportionality in this Gulf. And all I can say is that the Tories have woken up very, very late. Because a Reform has been saying abolish ULEZ for a very long time. Reform has been saying, you know, do away with the arbitrary net zero timetable and have something far more responsible and proportionate. Now, you know, Reform UK has been saying that. My message would be wake up and listen to what they're saying. The Tories are, you know, are only just catching up.
Most certainly. Now, Anne, Labour have doubled down on their eco policies, with Keir Starmer pledging to tear up North Sea oil and gas licences. And today, the deputy leader, Angela Rayner, said that the unpopular ULEZ scheme, which sees drivers pay £12.50 a day to get in their cars, will be rolled out across the country. Will Labour pay a political price for this?
Well, they already have in Uxbridge, and if they don't see that, then they're even more stupid than I thought they were anyway. So, yes, they will. They will pay a high price for that. And if they've decided to double down rather than listen to what the voters are saying, well, you know, that is going to come back and bite them, and it's going to bite them very hard. But as I say, the Tories are pretty slow on this. You know, they don't really want to back away from arbitrary targets. And they should do. And I think my generation, we've seen it all before. You know, we've seen the heat waves. We've seen this. We've seen that. We don't think that every last thing is down to global warming. And I think now people are beginning to wake up and say, yes, there is global warming. And yes, we do need to do something about it. But actually, you know, we're not all going to be extinct tomorrow morning.
Indeed so, completely, and the voice of reason. Now, blocking motorways, attacking a couple at their wedding. There seems to be a new low for Just Stop Oil every week, doesn't there? A couple of days ago, a mother wasn't able to get her sick child to hospital. Meanwhile, we've seen members of the public take the law into their own hands, Anne. It's become violent. As a former Home Office minister, would you like to see the police deliver a more robust response to these protesters who are breaking the law?
Well, I've been saying that for a very long time. Where are the police? You know, when that mother was trying to get a baby to hospital, where were the police? They are the law and order agency. There isn't anybody else. And if the police don't do their job, then it's quite inevitable that citizens, even very law-abiding, cautious citizens, are going to take the law into their own hands, not because they want to, but because they haven't got any darn choice. And really, the police need to wake up. The government needs to wake up. The whole thing should be tackled. Now, we've seen a very firm reaction from government on the banks following the Coutts chaos. Yeah. We should see an equally firm reaction towards Just Stop Oil. They're capable of stopping it. I don't mean stopping oil. I mean stopping the demonstrations.
Yeah.
They're capable of stopping it if only they had the will And the one thing this government has lacked throughout its entire term is will.
Anne, I've only got a couple of seconds left. What's your appraisal of those doomsday red weather maps, suggesting that, as you hinted there, the world will have, is going to blow up by next Tuesday?
No, really, again, I think people are waking up. They're waking up to the disproportionality of the message, particularly from the BBC. Everything is down to climate change. Polar bear only has to sneeze and it's all down to climate change. And people want a lot more proportionality. And they're not going to be scared now by weather maps like that. Because, as I say, you know, our generation has seen it all before.
Okay.
We've seen the forest fires. We've seen the heat waves. There's nothing new under the sun.